It's a scream, motherfuckers!
I used to be the guitar player in this band, and we didn't have a singer. And we couldn't find one that we were happy with, so we kind of were going in the booth one after another and seeing if anyone could do it. And I went in first and did it, and didn't know I could do it, it just happened. I mean, my singing has taken a lot longer, and it's drawn a lot from my influences. It is just rock and roll, it's raw, I sing with passion, I can't sing anything that I don't really feel. We're a heavy metal band with a rock and roll singer. However much people always assume this is a joke, and yes, I understand the humor behind it, the fear of not being famous keeps me motivated. I don't think I could do it. I don't want to be poor. I don't want to be unknown. I don't want to be a nobody again. Oh, I've been all those things before, and they weren't fun. I really didn't enjoy them. I had lots of problems with depression that led into my alcoholism and eventual drug addictions. I think just striving to be better keeps me motivated, not specific things. When you get thrown into something so fickle as fame at such a young age, you do tend to fall into the same old trap of being thrown everything, anything and anyone you want to get your hands on or your nose on. Addictions themselves are very difficult to overcome. And however much I've done them a lot of times, I've never been really overcoming them because I've fallen right back into it. It's a very, very difficult thing to go through. And I have some great people help me with MusiCares. And yeah, they're a great organization that helped me out a lot. I had my struggles with drink and drugs and women, but that was essentially what those first years were. There really wasn't anything musical or talent-wise going on besides bedroom drinking and drug talents. But I don't do them anymore, so it's all right. You can still love me. I discovered this. When you have sex with women that aren't your girlfriend gets mad. She gets angry about that. And it's just a part of the job is not a valid excuse. I want to change the reputation we have of being, I mean, everything's always been very, very negative that we've released so far, and this album has a lot of positivity and a lot of kind of good messages, like uplifting messages to give out to people. And I've really kind of focused on trying to put some good back into where I've put so much hatred and so much anger. I guess the next step, I'm going to try and get everyone else to sober up, and then we're going to kind of reinvent ourselves as a U2-esque peace band. We're not, they're twats. Fuck Bono!